In our today's video lecture, we will discuss in detail about the relation between heat capacity at constant volume and heat capacity at constant pressure. We will also prove that heat capacity at constant pressure is greater than heat capacity at constant volume. We will derive an equation which will relate the heat capacity at constant pressure and at constant volume and universal gas constant. Okay, first we will define molar specific heat or specific heat capacity of a gas. Molar specific heat or specific heat capacity of a gas is defined as the amount of heat required to rise the temperature of 1 mole of a gas by 1 Kelvin. Mathematically, del Q is the heat which we provide, the heat which leave or enter the system is denoted by del Q, where del T is the rise in the temperature of the gas. When we provide external temperature or heat to a system, it will result in the increase of the temperature of the system. Now we can write this equation as del Q directly proportional to N del T, where N denotes the number of moles. Now we can write this equation as del Q is equal to Cm N del T, where Cm is the constant of proportionality and this Cm is known as the molar specific heat or molar specific heat capacity. SI unit of molar specific heat capacity is joule per mole per Kelvin. Now we deal with molar specific heat at constant volume and molar specific heat at constant pressure. The equation which we have derived previously is del Q is equal to Cmn del T, but here we denote that equation with del Q into V for constant volume and Cvn del T. This is the heat capacity at constant volume, where for constant pressure we denote that equation with del Qp is equal to Cpn del T, where Cp is the heat capacity at constant pressure. Okay, now we deal with specific heat at constant volume. We know that specific heat at constant volume can be written as del Q into V is equal to Cv and del T, where Cv is the specific heat at constant volume. But according to first law of thermodynamics, we know that del Q when we provide a heat to a system is equal to the change in internal energy of the system and the work done on the system or the work done by the system. We also know that W is equal to P del V. This equation can be proved as W is equal to F dot S, where F is equal to, according to pressure, we know that pressure is defined as P is equal to F by A. Now from this equation we can derive the equation for F is equal to Pa, and Pa multiplied by S is equal to del V, which is a volume. Now we know W is equal to P del V. When there is no change in the volume, then the del V will be equal to zero. When del V is equal to zero, then the work done will be equal to zero. Now we put the value for work done in the first law of thermodynamics. We will get del Q at constant volume is equal to del V. This del V is the internal energy of the system, and the heat which we provide to the system will result in the increase of the internal temperature or increase in the internal energy of the system. Now by putting the value of this del QV at constant volume in this equation, which is the equation for specific heat at constant volume, we will get del U, change in the internal energy of the system, equal to specific heat and number of moles, and del T is the change in the temperature. So this is specific heat at constant volume. Now we deal with specific heat at constant pressure. The equation for specific heat at constant pressure can be written as del QP at constant pressure is equal to heat capacity at constant pressure and number of mole, and del T is the change in the temperature. Now again here we deal with the first law of thermodynamics. According to first law of thermodynamics, del QP at constant pressure is equal to del U plus del W. But this time there will occur a change in the volume and we will keep the pressure constant. So the external energy which enters or leaves the system at constant pressure, del QP, will be equal to change in the internal energy and the work done. The work done here is P del V. But according to ideal gas equation, we know that P del V is equal to NR del T, which can also be written as NK beta T, but here we write it as NRT, where R is the universal gas constant, N is the number of mole, and del T is the change in the temperature. This is ideal gas equation. From ideal gas equation, we have the value of P del V is equal to NR del T. Now putting these values for P del V, del U, which is equal to CV N del T, and del QP, del Q at constant pressure, and this equation, we will get CP N del T. This CP N del T is the value of del Q at constant pressure, which is equal to heat capacity at constant pressure and del T, where del U, this del U is equal to CV N del T, heat capacity at constant volume, number of mole, and change in the temperature. Now, and the third term, P del V is equal to NR del T. This is NR del T. Now, N will cancel with this N, and del T will cancel with del T on the left side. The remaining terms are heat capacity at constant pressure is equal to heat capacity at constant volume plus R. This equation proves that Cp is R time larger than Cv, or Cp is greater than Cv. We can also write this equation in the form Cp minus Cv is equal to R, where R is the universal gas constant and its value is R is equal to 8.315 joule per mole Kelvin. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe Easy Edu for more videos. Comment your questions. Thank you.